next C in the program is check. We want to check what type of material we are working with. So on this car that we will repair, is it high strength steel? Is it normal steel? Or is it aluminum? We can repair all three, but they react differently. So we need to know what we're working with before we start. The next important step while we're checking is not only checking the damage, but first make sure the temperature is right. One of the most important things for sure in winter is you want to make sure that you create the perfect temperature to work with. So check your temperature when the car comes in, and you want to be ideally around 25 to 30 degrees Celsius or around 70 to 80 Fahrenheit. Why? The best adhesion with the hot glue on paint is when the paint is warm. Not hot, warm. A cold car will shock your hot glue and it will drop off, or you will have no performance. So to make sure your temperature is exactly what we want, or in the range that we want, in between 75 and 80, we're checking the temperature. And right now it is 23 or 73 Fahrenheit. So if it would be colder, just take your heat gun. You don't want heat, but you want warmth. So check here again. We got 89, and that's about perfect to start glue pouring. The next check in the same checking procedure is checking the damage. Now, if you're looking at a damage in the dark or in a light, it makes a world of a difference. But we have the same difference with the lights we use to repair the cars. One of our lights is this Alimedon light. And how do we use the light? We want to light up the damage and make sure that before we start repairing, that we'll look at the damage into the lights, and the light will light up the whole area so we can check where do we want to start pulling, how big is the damage, how many details or smaller dents are there that we wouldn't see without the light. So you absolutely need to light up the repair with the correct light to read the dent through the light.